Welcome. Welcome to AUMP 1445 Automotive Climate Control Systems. I am your instructor, Mr. Sanchez. Thank you for taking this class. What is this class about? Air conditioning. The majority of this class deals with air conditioning. That's where we go today. You'll get one lesson on heaters. I'll wait to the hottest part of the summer for that one. I've divided the AC system into three main sections. The three sections are the refrigeration system. The refrigeration system is any part that touches the freon, the refrigerant. This is where we start today. The compressor has a circuit, the blower has a circuit, the cooling hands have circuits, the ventilation systems have circuits. You will have some lessons on electrical related directly to air conditioning. The last section is the ventilation system. I bet you can guess what that is. Let's get started. Today, we start with the refrigeration system. As I mentioned, any part that touches a freon is considered part of the refrigeration system. Freon, refrigerant, it's the same thing. The refrigeration system is well represented here on the screen. Most of the components that you see on the screen are refrigeration components. But do you see this over here? Can you see the little cursor? There's something electrical. And then back over here, the cursor in the back. That's something electrical. Let's go on. Okay, this is a nice view of the ventilation system. The activity that takes place inside the ventilation system is all part of the air conditioning. This is a more technical view of the ventilation system. We'll understand how the various doors control where the air comes in and where it goes and how we mix it with the heat and the cold. Are you ready, folks? What's this? Well, this is the AC compressor. This is probably the most recognizable AC component underneath the hood. There's a whole bunch of them. AC compressors, they kind of look the same, but they're kind of different. Here's some more. You're gonna have to find the AC compressor underneath the hood because you're gonna be interested in to see what the clutch is doing. Can you see the AC compressor yet? Well, let's help you out. Okay, you should know what this thing is. If you don't, maybe you should be taking something else. You're just gonna have to learn what a power steering pump looks like. And here's the air conditioning, and that's the water pump, and this is an emission control device. These are the components that are driven by the pulley. It is the clutch. That's what's going to identify. That's what's going to identify the compressor is the clutch. Here's a few more clutches. You see them? Kind of the same, a little bit different. They're in the front. Here on the left, we have part of the electrical circuit. This is that magnetic field that will create the magnetism that will draw the clutch for engagement. All right, there. Do we see the clutch? Over here in the lower right, that's the clutch. You're gonna be very interested to see if the clutch is rotating. That is absolutely the first test if the AC is not working. Is it engaged? Can you see the compressor? That's an easy one. Easy to find and easy to work on. There, compressors are somewhere over there on the last part of it. Why do we call it the compressor? Because it compresses. What does it compress? Refrigerant. Refrigerant is a more technical term. Freon, I think, is a good term also. Okay, the most common refrigerant today underneath the hood is R134A. I just call it 134. Some of the newer vehicles have the new freon. Who knows the name of the new freon? That one? Please don't call it 1234. That sounds so unprofessional. I like to call it 1234. Okay? The AC compressor is very much like an engine. It doesn't look like an engine, but it is. Let me take you inside. This is some of the early model, that means old model type of AC compressors. That's an AC compressor. That's the image. But I have better than the image. I have it right here. This is the same thing that I'm showing you. Those are two pistons, connecting rods, crankshaft. Boy, that's the cutest little crankshaft. A goo. Thank you. Most compressors look more like this. You can still see the cylinders, you can see the pistons, you can see the rings. Okay, let me introduce to you the wobble plate. This is a wobble plate. They call it a wobble plate because it wobbles. The wobbling action gives us the reciprocating action of a crankshaft. This doesn't look like a crankshaft, but it does the same job. It doesn't call a crankshaft, but it gives us that. Let me introduce to you the double-headed piston. Double-headed because there's two pistons on each side. And it's going to be the movement of the piston just like the original one. It just has a funny-looking crankshaft. All right, there. How many cylinders do you see? Well, of course you see three. But guess what? What you can't see is on the backside. On one side, you have three cylinders. And on the other side, you have three more cylinders. This is a six-cylinder compressor, just like an engine. Six-cylinder, five-cylinder, 10 cylinders. They have all different kinds of compressor cylinders. Why do compressors wear out? Let's take a good look. Can you see all the metal shavings in here? Can you see all the scoring in here? Let me give you another view. Okay, here the Teflon ring is non-functional. It's so badly scored. But what I want you to see, I hope you can see that cursor, is there's glitter. That's metal shavings. But what you don't see and should be there is a coating of oil. Everything that you see on here should have a film of coating, but it doesn't. I wonder where the oil went. Well, just like an engine. Engines leak oil. Guess what else leaks oil? The compressors leak oil. You see that UV dye on there? That compressor's leaking. Well, what's this? Let me give you a hint. That's the part that goes inside the dash. That's the part that gets cold. That's the evaporator. That's the new one. This evaporator is no good. It's leaking. That UV dye is all over it. Why is it leaking? It deteriorated from the inside. The friction of the refrigerant passing through the fins, it deteriorates it. Evaporators leak. This is a condenser. This is in the front of the engine, and maybe a rock hit it, or maybe deterioration took place. Condensers leak. Fittings leak, service fittings leak, connections leak, compressors leak, everything leaks. When the refrigeration components leak the refrigerant, they also leak the oil. And then all of a sudden, the compressor is running low on oil. When was the last time you checked your oil, compressor? The answer is never. I'll show you how to do that. Here we go. What else? What else wears out the compressor? This one does have an oil film on all the moving parts. Hey, we've taken these apart, and there should be oil in all the moving parts. Here, why is the Teflon ring out of its groove? Hey, not because it ran out of oil, right? Because it got too hot. This compressor overheated. Compressors get hot like an engine, overheat, and get damaged. There, the Teflon ring has decided to leave the groove. Compressors overheat. Why? Why do compressors overheat? Well, I've got five answers for you. Answer number one, anything that has to do with the condenser. If it's dirty, the compressor is starting to overheat. Here's another example of how condensers get dirty. This is causing the AC compressor to overheat. If the compressor could talk, it would scream, please clean that condenser. Second answer, stop and go driving. Why does stop and go driving overheat compressors? Well, I'll tell you, there's no ram air. What's ram air? Well, that's all that helpful air that's rushing in there to help cool the condenser and the radiator and other heat exchangers. Ram air is so important. Okay, answer number three, the cooling fans. Most late model, that means the latest thing, new vehicles have electric cooling fans. The condenser needs to be cooled off. This particular vehicle has two electric cooling fans. And if you've taken any of my classes, you will totally understand exactly what wears out. The brushes, the commutator, they're like a brake shoe and a rotor. The brushes are going to wear out. Here's a new brush, and then the brushes are going to wear out. The brushes are going to wear out. Okay, the commutator is going to wear out, and then these cooling fans are not going to work. Answer number four, a fan clutch. Some vehicles have this fan clutch. This particular fan clutch is no good. Why? Because of all the dust on it. Well, why is the dust there? Because the viscous fluid has leaked out. This fan clutch is slipping. It may turn, but it's not turning fast enough. It all has to do with the condenser, cooling the condenser. The last and final answer is yes. Aquí en Corpitos, we are in extreme severe heat operating conditions. Okay, anything over 90 degrees is considered extreme severe heat. This is what it feels like in the summertime here in South Texas. Okay, it's hot as hell. The way I see it, this damn heat is only good for one thing. And what's that? Any questions? The end.